Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, our third video on the gradient of a line segment, and this time we're dealing with gradients that may be fractional and what that means. So just a quick recap, can you remember the formula to work out the gradient if you have two sets of coordinates x1, y1, x2, y2? You need to commit that to memory. Do you remember? Well, hopefully you remembered it's the difference in y is y2 subtract 1, y1 divided by the difference in x is x2 subtract x1. Sometimes we just write diff y divided by diff x just to remind us. Next thing I want you to just practice, we've worked out the gradients where they've been positive whole numbers. We've worked out the gradients where they've been negative whole numbers. I want you to just double check you can work out these two gradients here and understand what they mean. So pause the video, work out the gradient of that line segment and the gradient of that line segment. Okay, you should have got the following. For the first one, you should have got a gradient of 2, and the second one, you should have got a gradient of negative 2. What does a gradient of 2 mean? It means as you go right 1, you go up 2. What does a gradient of negative 2 mean? As you go right 1, you go down 2. And let's check with the picture that that's actually right. This one is A here. As you go to the right 1, you go up 2, spot on. That's what gradient of 2 means, that works. And here in this case for B, as you go to the right 1, you go 1, 2 down. And that works in that case as well. So that's our interpretation of gradient, what it means. Positive gradient, positive number like 5, means you go right 1, up 5. Negative number like negative 5, you go right 1, you go down 5. Now we're going to try and understand what it means when you get a fractional answer. So let's have a go at a few. Okay, we're asked for each of these, work out the gradient of the line segment with these endpoints and interpret what your answer for the gradient means. So pause the video and for each of these, work out the gradient and see if you can interpret what the answer for the gradient means. Okay, the first one I'm not actually going to do live because it's an easy one. I've just done it, in fact, in the last slide. The gradient there should have been 2. And what that means is, as you go right 1, you go up 2. We know the interpretation of that. Now let's do these ones together. The gradient is the difference in y's, so the gradient for this one is going to equal 5 subtract 2 divided by the difference in x is 3 subtract 1. 5 subtract 2 is 3, 3 subtract 1 is 2, so it's 3 over 2, which you could write as 1.5, but I don't want you to. I want you to think of something different in a second. Now I'm going to come back to this one once I've done this one. Let's quickly do the gradient here as well. The gradient here is the difference in y, so 4 subtract 2 over the difference in x is 4 subtract 1. So in this case, 4 subtract 2 is 2 and 4 subtract 1 is 3, so we get 2/3. You could decimalize it as 0.6 recurring, but I don't want you to. I want us to be able to interpret what that means. How about we do it by drawing each of these pictures? 1, 2 to 3, 6. 1, 2 to 3, 6 looks something like that. 6 is there. Okay, that would be part A. That's 1, 2, 3, 6. Okay, what about this? 1, 2, 3, 5. Well, 1, 2, 3, 5 would look very similar to that, apart from it would be start here and it would go here like that. And that there would be 3, 5. And that would be B in blue there. And what would this one be? This is 1, 2, 4, 4. It's getting a bit cluttered here, but 1 across 2 up again. And 4, 4 would end up being here. Like that. And that's C. That's the 0.44. Now maybe this diagram can help us here. The gradient of 2, or you could think of it as 2 over 1, means as you go across 1, you go up 2. Okay? Right 1, up 2. Now the gradient of 3 over 2, if you look at part B, this one here, as you go across 2, you go up 3. As you go across 2, you go up 3. As you go right 2, you go up 3. Now, if you leave it in fraction form, it's really helpful. You can interpret it. The bottom number tells you how far to go across, and the top number tells you how far to go up associated with that movement across. So what do you think this means? Well, it must mean as you go to the right 3, you go up. As you go to the right 3, you go up 2. And let's check that's right. For this one here, as you go to the right, 1, 2, 3, you go up 1, 2. So leaving your gradients in fraction forms is dead useful, because if, say, you had a fraction of 2 over 7, that means as you go across 7, you go up 2. If you had a fraction of 7 over 2, that means as you go to the right 2, you go up 7. So leaving it like this is really helpful for us to interpret what the gradient means. Let's have go some more when we get a negative answer. Pause the video here and have a go at working out the gradient in each of these cases, and you're going to get negative answers. Okay, this one I'm not going to do for us because I've done it before, but that one there, you get a whole number, negative 2. Now, what does that mean? It means as you go to the right 1, you go down 2. Now, let's do the others together. This one here, the gradient, is going to be the difference in y's, so it's negative 5, subtract 2, divided by the difference in x's, which is 0, subtract negative 3. Negative 5 subtract 2 is negative 7. 0 subtract negative 3 is positive 3. So this is negative 7 over 3, which we can write as negative 7/3. Now, how do you think we could interpret that? Well, remember the bottom number. As we go to the right by 3, negative 7, we go down 7. So as we go to the right by 3, we go down 7 here. And that's how we can interpret it. We will check afterwards with a picture. Let's do the next one, see if we can work that out and interpret it. The gradient here, well, that's going to be the difference in y's, 4 subtract 2, divided by the difference in x's, 1 subtract 4, which is going to equal 4 subtract 2 is 2, over negative 3, which we could say is negative 2/3. How can we interpret that? As we go to the right by 3, because the overall answer is negative, we're going down 2. Okay? And let's actually draw those pictures and double check. I'm just going to draw this one and this one. There's no point in drawing the others. Negative 3, 2 would be here, and it goes to 0, negative 5. So it goes like that. And that's B. And let's do this one here. 4, 2 would be over here at 4 and 2. And it goes to 1, 4, so it goes to 1, 4 like that. And that's C. Now let's see if this is right for B. As you go, we're saying right 3, you go down 7. As you go 1, 2, 3 to the right, you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes, our little way of thinking of it worked. And what about here? As you go to the right 3, you go down 2, 1, 2, 3, you go down to. Absolutely. So that worked as well in negative cases. So that's it for this particular video, where we talked about what it means to have a fractional gradient. Tune in for the next video, where we summarize it all together, all the different cases you can have for the gradient of a line segment. Thanks for watching.